Lucas, I need you to be careful with this one. Anti-royalist pamphlets have been cropping up and tensions are high. The Queen is very nervous about security. This way. This way. Here we are. Good luck.
I should return and find out about this. Well now, I didn't ask about this.
Please, leave the room for a moment. No one is permitted to see me open the safe.
Imagine that someone was after the scepter. I must see it. I ordered the scepter with the dove to be brought from the tower for tonight's event. Thank heavens! It is untouched. Poor man. I arrived to find him here, dead as you see him. He gave his life to defend my person. Only I know the combination. The vault contains the very precious scepter with the dove, which I've chosen to be used in tonight's knighthood ceremony. This evening, I will knight several industrialists that have worked to end the practice of child labor. All of London's luminaries are invited.
I should return and find out about this.
He said he was onto something. Said everything added in clues. You know, when he thought something was important, he'd write it up in invisible ink. Lemon juice-like. I did see Artie's friend, Mr. Raymond. He'd just come from Perlock Publishing with his new Penny Dreadful. Seemed very excited about it. I never liked him much. He'd use smoke to read it. If you have a way to make smoke, you can see what it says.
Artie's been all in a state. Thinks there's some sort of master criminal on the loose. Then this morning, he's gone. Come to think of it, he had been going on about the Queen and all for the last day or two. Seemed to think she was in some sort of trouble.
Well now, I didn't ask about this.
is planning an explosion at the palace. It must be evacuated. Steady on.
There's at least 100 people here for the knighthood ceremony. The Queen will use the scepter with the...
Your lives are in danger!
Do as you're told. Terribly nice to see you.
Run! Out!
Whatever is happening?
Why is nothing happening? Nothing? What's going on? I've been tricked! Raymond! Why has he done this?
You are more naive than you appear.
Look beyond the obvious, beyond surface appearances.
No.
Nothing but a showman. So many people makes everything more dramatic.
Look beyond the obvious, beyond surface appearances.
Seems to me you've created the perfect diversion, haven't you? You've helped me herd all those dreary people to certain death. We shall hear the explosion presently. I found the same clues you found. I knew there was to be an explosion, and I led you here to save everyone. I'm as mystified as you are that nothing happened. Quite right.
All right, no, I'll have any more of this. No, absolutely not.
I brought him his invitation to the knighthood ceremony, the one with the special scepter.
Never trust a man who tells you what you want to hear. He's...
While you were chasing all those people around, I absconded with the Queen. A hefty ransom is now due. I needed you to distract everyone so that I could quietly assassinate Her Majesty the Queen. A man like me can take anything he wants, even the Queen's most beloved item of all her crown jewels, the priceless and symbolic scepter with the dove. The scepter with the dove taken with your help. What could better display my genius?
No one questions you when you wear a uniform.
I suspect the solution will turn on geometry.
I am a fellow of many skills. Cracking a safe is but one. I threatened the Queen with her very life. She told me the combination in a thrice. I simply watched the Queen open the safe when you arrived. Quite right. The dead guard was I. The spider venom allowed me to fake my death. I had a perfect view from where I lay. I have stolen the Queen's most prized possession. The scepter with the dove. Think of it. I have outfoxed you, the most cunning detective in Britain. I mocked you by leaving clues for you at every turning point. Now I have the scepter. Proof positive of my superiority.
Jacob! Wake up! It's Raymond! He's taken Artie hostage! They're on the roof! Evie's here to help you, Jacob!
Don't worry, Jacob. He won't know it's coming. I suppose this means our detective days are over. But what about you, Artie?
I'm glad I survived Mr. Raymond's insanity, but sadly he won't be here anymore to write more books.
A great loss, I'm sure.
I'm quite serious, Miss Evie. Me and my friends waited every week to read the next number and find out what happened next.
Why don't you write some yourself?
A fellow would have to be very clever indeed.
Sounds like you'd be in your element, my dear.
The gruesome Whitechapel murders by Artie.
I should think I would use my full name, by Artie Conan Doyle.
But he's Arthur. Sounds more of a serious fellow.
A letter. For me.
Good day, sir.
Thank you.
You should see what's waiting for you at Whitechapel Station. Nigel wants to make up for things, so he got you a gift.
Oi, Mr. Fry, come have a look at this.
Ain't she a beauty?
Oh, well done, Nigel.
Yeah, I nicked it off the gang across town, got them all stewed, and then took it when they was asleep. Here, sir, let me show you. It's jammed. Oh, shit. Move!
Nigel.
We've got our double carriage!
I'm commissioning the Royal Artillery. We may have to wait.
A letter. For me?
Mr. Fry, I hope you're having a fine day.
A dinner invitation.
And with whom are you dining this evening?
Maxwell Roth.
The leader of the Blighters? You're not going.
Of course not. Better check the back. I'm here to see Mr. Roth.
Weapons?
No, thank you. I've got my own.
You should be on the stage, sir. This way.
Guest has arrived. Come, sit. I've had my eye on you for some time. I find your heroics in battling the great Crawford Sterrick. Quite magnificent.
I've been picking off your soldiers one by one. Doesn't that make you angry?
On the contrary. Surprise is a spice of life. Now, Mr. Sterrick, that's a different story. I'm drowning in directives, all terribly boring. Let's say we work together and bring him down.
I'm not so sure about that.
My friend, if I fail to provide you with the chance to cause Sterrick some pain, well, you can charge into this theater and kill me yourself.
What do you get out of all this?
The chance to have a little fun with the bravest man in London.
You have a deal.
Lewis, my carriage. Shall we? This way. Well, you don't expect me to go alone, do you? Take the reins.
Walk on, girl.
Driver, to St. Pancras. And don't spare the horses.
I thought you and Sterrick would be fighting for the same ends. What happened?
You know. He required my services to train his gangers. But the man is dreadful.
You don't say.
Freedom, Jake. Stealing that is far more than a sin. It denies us our humanity.
Right you are. And St. Pancras will ease our suffering.
The station contains a large shipment of explosives to be dispatched to Sterrick & Co.
And you intend to steal it?
What? No. There's a train parked inside St. Pancras.
Then I'm to do away with Sterrick's merchandise, leaving chaos in my wake?
Why not, Jacob? Why not? As we speak, the up train is headed towards us. That may help you enter the station unseen.
As long as it remains on the tracks.
I'd say good luck, but you don't need it. I shall make certain any reinforcements from Sterrick are kept away from the station.
Thank you. find you, I'll string you up.
Someday, you blighters will understand that I'm doing this for your own good. Two down. Be ashamed to stop now.
Yeah. have been better off if we had these explosives months ago.
That's a fact. My brother is dead because of a rock attack.
One shipment left.
To find somebody to drive this hunk of metal.
Off me. What do you think you're up to?
Hush now, please. Do be quiet, sir. No need to make a fuss.
What do you want from me?
I just need you to keep the engine stoked.
All right, I'll help you. Don't hurt me.
Think of me as another passenger. I just happen to have a rather large blade pointed at your back. Is to get up some steam.
Will be on his knees in no time. My hat is off to you. Apologies, I must run. Do come see me again.
You've done a wonderful job of helping the children of this city.
So what you're saying is, I'm a hero.
We pitched in what we could to properly express our gratitude.
Thank you, Clara.
Jacob. He is beautiful, isn't he? I planned a perfect second outing for us.
Have you?
There's borrowing to be done. Three of Starrick's henchmen are about to disappear.
Oh, you sly devil.
Oh, and I'm coming along this time. There is no sense in giving you all the glory. Off to my carriage we go. Lewis! Cowardly fools under Starrick have built their own prisons. It's a dreadful waste.
They could be building gangs instead.
No, no. Why build when you can ebb and flow like the sea? I would not aim to pin them down.
Oh, you wouldn't, would you?
I dare say I shall never tire of the National Gallery.
Why does Starrick interest himself with art?
He's hired a fiendishly...
Bring your carriage around and wait for the cargo. I shan't be very long.
Someone around here must know Miss Hattie Cadwallader. I'm looking for Miss Hattie Cadwallader.
Ain't seen her. I knows what she's been up to, though.
And what's that?
Friggin' art, sir. She finished a statue not far from here.
The statue must be around here somewhere. Hey, Smalley. Know anything about what happened here?
I saw who painted it, sir.
Miss Cadwallader?
She hides down the sewers, sir.
Of course it's sewers. Why the bloody sewers?
His next delivery's on its way. And tell him, too, that I've grown tired of these working conditions.
Wasn't Starrick who sent me.
Then who?
Maxwell Roth sends his regards.
Let's have it!
this, Catwoman. What a pleasant surprise.
You'll be hearing from Mr. Starrick, Roth.
Why the Alhambra?
I look forward to it. Every good criminal needs a place to invest his ill-gotten gains. And what's better than distracting the world with a little light entertainment while you do so?
Oh, come now. You can't tell me you don't enjoy the triumph of a well-received play. The plaudits and praise, the reviews.
Ah, the pub. The dwelling place of Starrick's head of security, one called Benjamin Raffles. Those who cross him tend to disappear without warning.
Sounds like we'll be fast friends.
Be careful. His guards are never far away.
Looks like a mess.
Whoa, there!
Please make sure to come again.
Yeah! Yeah!
down now! Who's a good horse? You are. Easy now! That's a girl.
Try to stop me. What's the meaning of this? Did Rob send you? The villain.
At least you're out of the stink.
You have your villains
my
mixed up, Mr. Raffles.
Fragrant Raffles.
The man you work
How very
for is
good
the real
to see
villain
you again.
Here.
Catterwell, Rob. It's into the back with
Who
you.
Who is this
then.
Lewis that works for you?
Ah, a bit of an old fish, isn't it? To me a few years past.
He's very solemn.
But always so polite.
Who am I looking for?
Chester Swine. A copper by day and snitch by night. Remove him from the pack and you count Starrick's ties to the police force.
He must be good at what he does to keep the charade going for so long.
He is indeed, dear boy.
Easy does it. All these bobbies give me goose flesh.
Welcome to Scotland Yard.
Thank you.
second chance policy, V. Don't push it any further. Where's he from, then?
This.
I could have sworn he was here.
He's show there.
No mercy! Bye, baby Bunting! Daddy's gonna hunt him!
Come on!
Something happening? Stop that, mate! I'm coming!
That's enough of your lip!
Huh? What?
Now, Swineborn. Let's not make a scene.
You're not going to get away with this!
Oh, but I am.
Where are you taking me?
A friend would like to say a quick how do you do.
Excellent work. Do come find me at the Alhambra. I have more amusements planned for us.